Right.
Well, let's go ahead and get to our first guest this morning, because we are super excited to get somewhat of an update on the much anticipated pier, the new St. Pete Pier, and what is to come. We know that the grand opening has been postponed a little bit, but joining us now, we have Dwayne from Tampa Bay Watch Discovery Center, which is now going to be a part of this new pier. And Dwayne, I was just so excited. You're actually joining us from the new pier. This is the first time we've gotten a look at it.
I am. This is a should be a discreet broadcast, but actually we're inside the Discovery Center, so it is a sneak peek. If you hear hammering, it's because there actually are contractors still working outside the building, but we are getting very close on the pier. We're looking forward to opening as soon as possible.
I'm so excited to chat with you. And actually, I'm learning a little bit about Tampa Bay's past. I had no idea that Tampa Bay itself was polluted, was not looking good. Even nationally, they were talking about it. So part of this project is to reflect on the rebuilding in a way, right?
That's correct. Tampa Bay Watch has been around since 1993, and we've been actively engaged in cleaning up, preserving, and protecting Tampa Bay since then. A lot of that is water clarity, but really dealing with pollution issues and making sure that Tampa Bay is here for future generations in the right way. And it has been an incredible U-turn that has occurred with a lot of support from some other organizations, including the EPA and Tampa Bay Estuary Programs. But this is phenomenal. It's actually a great model for other cities that are experiencing some other problems with pollution.
So talk about what's behind you, what we can see when we actually come out to visit the pier, because this really is a hands-on experience and exhibits from what I understand.
It is. We have some great new exhibits that are a lot of fun. Right behind me is our new mangrove estuary tank, or we call the estuary habitat, and that will be filled with local species that you can see up close and in person. We've got this incredible exhibit that you can't see this behind me called Life in the Bay, which is a digital sandbox. You actually put your hands in there and you create topography with the sand, and different species pop out. And of course, the other one we're very, very proud of is the 1 second wave of plastic, which represents roughly, it's a sculpture of 1,500 water bottles that represents what we use in the United States in 1 second in plastic use, in plastic bottles. It's amazing. It's very humbling to see that, know what kind of impact we're making individually in the environment.
Why do you think this location was so key and now is going to work out so great for what you're able to do with Tampa Bay Watch Discovery Center and having it right there on the pier, which, I mean, are there any better views of the bay than right there?
We're blessed. We get to come out and see this every day, and it's remarkable. For Tampa Bay Watch, our home office is located in Tierra Verde, and so we're a little bit off the beaten path. And this gives us a public face, a public profile and location for people to learn more about what we do and then what they can do to help the environment every day. Simple things that they can do that make a difference.
You know, what's interesting, Dwayne, is this is going to be something, it's such a focal point for both locals and then both for tourists and visitors that come to the Bay Area. Talk about when it comes to education, why I'd imagine you guys probably had to take that into consideration a little bit, again, about how important it is for locals and then people from really all over the world that'll eventually come back and head to this spot.
We think the education is critical. It's a key component of what it is that we do. Here, we're very focused on being able to provide opportunities for some of the students that are nearby that had never really been to the water. One of the things we'll be bringing online this January will be a new floating classroom that will allow students to go out on a boat in the water. We'll do a trawl and they'll get to see some species up close. And it's kind of sad that we're that close and a lot of kids haven't been on a boat before. So we think that's a critical component. One of the things we're really excited about are our public programs. We have this, what's called the Wet Classroom, which is a small amphitheater outside of our front door that goes right down to the water. And we'll be doing free programs on a daily basis out there for passerbys that get to, that can engage and participate for the whole family. And it's going to be a lot of fun. We have some secrets around that because we're doing some things that have never been done before, and they're just going to be remarkable. You're going to have to see it.
Secrets. That's how you tease, Dwayne. That's what we do in television here. So in closing, can you give any more secrets or teasers as far as pier opening date, what you're looking at now? What are we hearing so that we can make sure and get people at home? I know they're going to want to be the first in line to visit you.
Absolutely. So unfortunately, we don't have the opening date either. That's a secret that's being held by the city as they're working out post-COVID response. But we do know that it's going to open this summer. And we do know that there's going to be a lot of publicity around that. I think part of the concern was making sure that people can adequately social distance and enjoy it. And so that's what they're working on right now. But it is going to be remarkable. You're going to want to see it. This is, I've never seen anything like this in the world. This is just an incredible location.
We need things to look forward to. We need things that, you know, that gets us excited these days. This is it. We can't wait to see it in person. Dwayne, thank you so much for joining us this morning.
Thank you. It was great to speak with you both. We look forward to seeing you down here this summer.
You got it. Take care, Dwayne.